All I'm saying is, like, seriously, consider your source. The woman had to sacrifice her pet lamb, Chocho, when she was, like, 8 to help feed the family.
It was a goat.
Whatever, Lex. I'm just saying, look at who you're dealing with before you end up losing your mind. Oh, before I forget, we have a meeting with Mikey in, like, 20 at Comic Circuit. So wash your mug and giddy up, partner. We got to get this party started. Go, go, go. Hey, Rob. Yes, I'm thinking about it. I know the ceilings are low, but she's freaking Filipino. How much headroom could she possibly need?
Got your stack in the back.
Okay.
Give me a sec.
No problem. You take your time. I'm not going anywhere. Don't rush on my account.
So cute. Ew.
What?
Are you just flirting with a 13-year-old?
He is 19.
He is a fetus. You are creepy.
Perfectly legal.
I respected you 25
seconds. He can vote, can he? Hey, the younger the better.
Come to me. I beg you not to finish that sentence. Poor Favies. What are we supposed to be looking for anyway?
Inspiration.
Is this where you come to find the nerd of your dreams?
Well, it depends. Are you a nerd?
No. I don't know. Actually, maybe I didn't. I'm not sure.
Well, that's too bad. Because then my answer would have been yes.
Dad, look who I found.
Okay, what happened last night, and who is this kid?
The Young of the Berry.
Okay, I'm gonna go look for Batman issue 515. I will be right back.
There's no way I even know anything about that issue, so stay here.
Who are you?
So,
Can I take you out? I'd like to take you somewhere.
Somewhere sounds great.
Tonight? Make a few calls, see if I can find a setup.
No way! Hal Jordan is a way better GLs!
Wrong. Kyle Rayner can beat him hands down.
You're insane.
Bingo.
You owe me.
I know.
Big.
I know.
Ew. Really? Ponytail?
It's not very sexy, Lexi. I'm just...
But it's the only way that I could get rid of my grays.
Or hair dye.
Dude, I don't have the money to do regular upkeeps.
Oh, my God. Because the last time I checked, Clairol was like $4.
Do I look desperate?
Yeah, a little bit. Manufactured happiness is not gonna get you laid.
Yeah, but it's definitely gonna get me through tonight. So you're a serial killer.
Well, serial killers usually get paid more. Mm-hmm. They got more lines. They have ransoms to request, threats to make, and negotiations to work out with the 5-0.
Fascinating. I've never met a reenactment actor before. I can't believe that I'm sitting here with the Green River Killer. Kind of freaky. So, is that your long story?
No, but it does lead into it. I met my long story playing Ted Bundy. And she was cast as one of my victims. It's pretty romantic, huh?
Very, very romantic. So is this one of those, like, to be continued or tune in next week kind of stories?
No. It's a the end kind of story. It's over.
So did she stay in L.A. to pursue the dream?
No, she's living the dream. She's one of the biggest novella stars out there. She even managed to make People in Espanol's top 10 most beautiful women.
Me too. So that's, I mean, that's really...
Spooky.
So, I mean, if she's all that, why would the divorce?
Well, exactly that. She thought she was all that, and she wanted an all that kind of guy to be at her side.
And you're not an all that kind of guy. Oh, sorry, I didn't mean that like that.
No, it's all good. Hey, you know, I should call home and check in on Mimo.
Yeah, or relieve Mimo, right?
Yeah, more like save Kayla. Your story's next.
Oh, yeah, I played the fifth.
Oh, yes, there's no way in hell. Hello there, buddy. How you doing?
That's kind of you. Thanks for the flowers.
Sure. I didn't know you weren't a fan of things that died.
Yeah, well, I'm working on that, okay? This is so beautiful. So, you went. What do you want to know about me?
Well, the drama.
Uh-oh.
That's what makes a good story.
Uh-oh, well, of course. I followed my perfect husband to California about 4 years ago for the perfect job as the perfect entertainment lawyer extraordinaire to the stars. We were high school sweethearts, voted most likely to live happily ever after, and my parents absolutely adored him.
Wow.
Yep.
Pressure.
Yeah, you're telling me. You know Paper Hero's ideal? The perfect show dog. Bring him in front of the audience, and he's trained and groomed, and take him behind stage, and he bites and growls like Cujo.
Cujo eventually got what was coming to him.
Yep. So did Daniel.
Seriously? Dude croaked?
Yep. Not so happily ever after. After all.
Oh, man, I'm so sorry.
You know, I still don't know what hurts more, the fact that the police report listed his death as vehicular blowjob, or the fact that I never got to tell him to go to hell. You know, just...
Wow. When I asked for drama, I sure got it.
You're welcome.
You know, as they say, you know, let bygones be bygones, right?
Yeah. Tell my mother that. Yeah, we should probably go, right? It's getting really late, and I have to wake up early in the morning, and I have to go meet this old associate to nail a chimp. Nail down a chimp. Nail down a chimp is what I meant, you know? Not to mention the fact that I don't have a DJ or a photographer or a superhero to save my life.
We can get looted DJ for you. But the guy owes me big. I mean, he's got a bar bill he'll not be able to pay off.
Really?
Yeah.
Because, I mean, that would be awesome.
And I, you know, may not be a professional photographer or anything, but I've taken my fair share of pictures over the years of, you know, Mimo and the spouse. Like, I could do that for you if you want.
What's the catch?
It's the second day.
Consisted of dwarfs, princesses, warriors.
Lucky charms.
Hot.
Oh.
What?
Maybe it was the grays that kept you from getting the second base.
Oh. She must have thrown in the towel. Well, I'm gonna go to bed. It's late.
You coming up?
You know, I'm gonna get a snack.
Didn't you just eat?
No. It was a first date. You don't eat on the first date.
Wow, it's been that long? Must have forgotten the rules. All right, I love you. Don't stay up too late, please.
Love you.